Well, Hellfire has rocked the riff. A bat with another metalhead in me. Bat with some more Charlie Griffiths. I can't say his name right. I am so fucking excited for this album. Like, I can't express how excited I am. This dude lives my dream. He plays for Kiesel. He gets to tour with a band called Haken, and they are fantastic. This is the newest track release, Luminous Beings. And I saw in the description it is featuring the ex-singer of Textures. Now there's two, which Textures is a band for any prog metal people that if you haven't listened to them, their album Silhouettes and their album Dualism are two of the best albums prog metal has. And then they were doing a two-part album, Phenotype or something like that, but they never released the second half. I don't know exactly the details, but either way, Silhouettes, Dualism, go check those two albums out. They are the fucking bomb. I am thirsty. And let's dive on in. Dimitalox. Talix. Take this riff already. Can't tell if this singer is the one from Silhouettes or the one from Dualism. Either way, I think both of them are fantastic singers. The guy in Silhouettes, like, I don't know, I kind of lean towards him because that dude had these fucking awesome cleans and awesome screams. But at the same time, the guy that did Dualism isn't far behind. I mean, it's kind of apples and apples. But I am curious which one is doing the vocals for this track. So all I gotta say is not only was that lead work fucking smooth, that bass tone is killer so far. Hey, Timmy Takas. Oh shit, radioactive fish. Oh, that's where Timmy come from. So cool. It sounds like it's a solo underwater. Oh, Charlie. Dude, if you did a whole album with this vocalist, I think this is the guy from Dualism. Him and the dude from Silhouette sound very similar, but this guy, he had more of the, his stuff was normally sounded higher in key to me, I guess is a way to put it, maybe. I don't know. Like, my ears thought they sounded similar, but at the same time, when you have the whole band the same playing behind you, it's easy to mimic, I guess. But so far, I think it's safe for me to say this is my favorite track that Charlie Griffiths has released so far for this album. That is a badass Keezle. I want one. That's cool. Made me want to learn how to sweet pick. I can't sweet pick to save my life. I don't know how people do it. Yeah, Timmy, get pissed. Dig that harmony effect he's got going on. I'm curious if he's harmonizing with himself or if it's like a multiplier, or I don't know. I don't know enough about vocals or how they're recorded nowadays. But it sounds that I like the fullness sound of it. I mean, it's super affected. It's a super effect. It's kind of like gives me the Britney Slays kind of thing that she does in Unleash the Archers. But it's really working. The more I listen to it, the more I'm like, I shouldn't have been so negative about it at first, but it really does. It's the same concept as a guitarist. When I do solos, I love a delay, and it just helps my solo stuff sound fuller. In the Ice Age. Now with Walking Fish. Oh shit, there he is. Tiktaalik. Okay. I dig that. That is a cool track. This little solo section was pretty slick. I do think Charlie went a little more ham. I mean, yeah, he went more ham in the second single or second track that was released, Tick to Lick, I guess is how I need to start saying it. Don't know. The singer that's featured in this track, I love, and hearing what can be done with his vocals in the band such as Textures. I kind of hoped near the later half of the song we would have went just a little more intricate with the whole the crawl, walk, run, and then that little chant thing he was doing before. I still think this is a good song, and I guess if I try to put it in the context of how I'm going to listen to the album and what I hope is happening with the album is that every track bleeds into itself. And the way this ends is it sounds like it's just gonna bleed into the next one. And it's gonna be one whole long song, which is my favorite thing. I love an album that does that. It's like the first single he released that featured the singer from Between the Buried and Me, their newest record, Colors 2. And I'm not even a big BT Band fan. My drummer I work with is huge into him. And he talked me into giving it a chance, and now Colors 2 is like one of my favorite albums. I love how that album just goes places. It takes you across the universe, and it all bleeds together. I think that is such a badass thing. Charlie, you are one of my heroes. You live the life I want to live. I like how chill you are with the Chevy hat and the Cracker Barrel Punch shirt. And that Kiesel is badass. I can't remember what model that is, because they've got a couple. I don't think it's the Lightspeed. Maybe it is the Lightspeed, because they got the X model, the Lightspeed, the Hyperdrive. That all make me think of that. But I'm trying to remember which one's the headless version. Either way, I would give this track four horns. It seems. In Haken's and Charlie Griffith's and that their style of writing, or his style of writing, it seems like this is an interlude track into the next one, and it's still really good. I dig it. I already gave it four horns, I think. Oh me, I'm just now it just wet my whistle, and I want the rest of the fucking album. I'm so ready for the rest of the fucking album to come out. And for everybody that checks this out, please leave a like, subscribe, leave some comments, let me know what y'all's thoughts are. Give me some more stuff to check out. And with that being said, stay positive, stay rocking, and I'll catch y'all on the next one.